sophomore at Gothenburg High School.
Wow!
My poem was titled, They Whisper. It whispers in my ears at night, talking when I try to sleep. It sings loudest in the night when I'm alone, but the voice whispers during the day. You are not good enough. What makes you think that they will be different than the others? Why do you think that this time will be different? It follows me day and night. If you see me in the hall, I'll flash you a jaunty smile, wink, crack a joke or two, or do something stupid just to get out a smile from a sad face. At least, that is how people see me. That is not the real me. The real me sits alone in my dark, Star Wars-themed room, shaking for memories, and all of a sudden I'm gasping for breath like a man who is drowning in a sea of deep red, struggling as blood pounds through my veins and heart throbbing so loud that I can't hear. I can't hear, I can't breathe, and my brain cries out for help. The real me sits in my bed at night with a short, sharp knife in one hand and a slender pen in the other, trying to decide whether to write my pain on a notebook or on my skin. I cringe as I feel the smooth blade of the knife running across my pale skin, and tears run down my face as an inner agony finds an audible voice, an agonized cry escaping from the depths of my soul, finally finding a voice. With tears running down my cheeks and blood running down my skin, I drop the knife, put my head, my hands, and sob. I weep until I can weep no more and fall into an agonized sleep. The real me is a monster. The blackness of depression stains my soul, and the horrors of PTSD rage through my mind, scarring and reopening old wounds that I would much rather leave alone. Once again, I sit with the knife and the pen, looking from one to the other. The voices in my head are overpowering. But then, a new voice appears. I love you, says. You are worth it. I still write a story, but this time I do not write it on my skin. Now I write in ink. Sometimes the things I write of leave me hunched over, shaking and gasping for breath, with the blood pounding in my ears and the echoes of my past roaring in my brain of voices.